What's up? I'm Christiane Cordero, and this is the 734 from WCCO. We know most of you are on your way to work, maybe about to head out the door, so let's get you started with today's weather. No surprise by now that we are above average still with our highs this week. Potentially seeing some sunshine throughout the day, and then clouds are going to take over later tonight, topping out at 36 degrees. Now let's talk about this. It's Fat Tuesday. Happy Fat Tuesday for everybody who celebrates. What do you do to celebrate? Let's take a live look, though, at Earth Cam as the sun rises on Bourbon Street. The sun has risen. There's that one guy with a bike out there in New Orleans. This, of course, is where thousands of people will celebrate Mardi Gras today. It's the last day before Lent begins for Christians on Ash Wednesday tomorrow. And that is why it's often associated with overindulging on food and drink. So we want to know, how are you celebrating? How do you indulge? Do you partake? Do you take this as an excuse to have maybe a puchki, a donut, Polish donut? Do you give something up for Lent? Let us know. What do you think? Those watching on Facebook, leave a comment right here, and we'll get through a few of those in just a moment. Big night tonight, though, for the Democrats, the last before South Carolina's primary on Saturday and Super Tuesday next week. We're talking about the debate, of course. The top seven presidential candidates, including Senator Amy Klobuchar, face off tonight in South Carolina. Klobuchar is polling in fifth place in South Carolina and some Super Tuesday states. So she, along with five other presidential hopefuls, spoke at a dinner in South Carolina last night.
And if you want to win big in this election with a big coalition, with a big tent, with long coattails, I know you and I will fight for you.
Joe Biden is the current front runner in South Carolina, but polls show Bernie Sanders is gaining ground. You can watch the debate. That's 7 p.m. on WCCO. Have the candidates been texting you? We wanted to look into how this works exactly. It's like the next generation door knock. Pretty cheap to do, definitely a lot of work, and maybe even strangely intimate.
Did it address you personally?
Yeah, with my first name.
Is that weird?
It is weird. But I mean, it's probably call list that they purchase, and so through the computer, it knows your number and your name.
Yeah, that's right. John Coleman, the dean at the U's Liberal Arts School, explained how firms get your number. Think voter registration, maybe some events you've attended, even other websites where you've entered your number in online. Then they can create a profile of what kind of voter you are. Here's the thing, love them or hate them, campaign texts work. Compared to mailers, they're super cheap. Compared to emails, they're actually red, so expect them to stick around. Hennepin County's top prosecutor is defending a murder conviction that's become an issue in Amy Klobuchar's presidential campaign. Mike Freeman released his response to questions surrounding the murder of 11-year-old Taisha Edwards. A bullet flew into her home and killed her. Back in 2002, Mayon Burrell was convicted of the crime, but earlier this month, the American Civil Liberties Union of Minnesota called for another investigation after an Associated Press report raised questions about the case. Senator Klobuchar was the Hennepin County attorney at the time. In an interview with ABC News, Burrell says he still blames her for being convicted.
Personally, I feel like she is the source of everything that happened with her charging me. You never took the time to look into this case. You never took the time to go and actually see, is this true or is this false? You know what I mean? And when she did that, she opened, I believe that she gave the police free rein and said, just bring me back a conviction.
Some have demanded Klobuchar drop out of the presidential race because of this. Freeman went on to say, quote, Amy Klobuchar was not the trial attorney on the case. It should not be treated like a political football. This office will continue to focus on the facts and will not let the politics of the movement influence that review of the facts. Harvey Weinstein is waking up in the hospital this morning. He was rushed there after complaining about chest pain. He was taken to the hospital shortly after he was found guilty of rape and sexual assault. Weinstein faces up to 29 years in prison. His sentencing is set for March 11th. We've learned a Minnesotan is being tested for coronavirus after visiting Southeast Asia. And this morning, Wall Street looks to bounce back from coronavirus concerns. The Dow fell more than 1,000 points, erasing gains for 2020. But futures this morning are pointing to positive opening, up 100 points. as that goes with the stock market. The coronavirus could also impact Amazon's Prime Day. It's not until July, but the outbreak has closed factories and slowed production of many products, including parts for Apple iPhones, other electronics, and clothing. The New York Times says Amazon is now concerned it could run out of stock of many of its Chinese-made products. Classes are canceled at a Minneapolis school today after a mistake by a construction crew created a serious mess.
Oh my, look at that. That's all sand.
Gross. Yep, that's what that looked like yesterday at Annunciation Catholic School. The construction crews cracked an underground sewer line, sending dirty water everywhere. The flooding did major damage. The school hasn't said when exactly it will reopen. Hundreds of thousands of Minnesotans have discovered the hurry up and wait that is the real ID.
I was hoping it was only going to be an hour or two.
I got here and I expected it to be maybe an hour.
Surprise, both were wrong. Instead, it took both of them close to, get this, 5 hours. DBS officials tell us that they are processing real ID applications all the way back on January 3rd. It goes back even further for an enhanced ID. DBS is taking steps to speed things up. You'll need a real ID or a passport to fly domestically come October. Los Angeles had a day to heal yesterday as thousands of people paid tribute to Kobe Bryant and his daughter. Vanessa Bryant spoke courageously, emotionally, and publicly for the first time about the loss of her husband and daughter.
I couldn't see him as a celebrity, nor just an incredible basketball player. He was my sweet husband and the beautiful father of our children. He was mine. He was my everything. I missed her sweet kisses. I missed her cleverness. I miss her sarcasm, her wit.
Kobe and Gianna Bryant were among 9 people killed in a helicopter crash last month. The Staples Center was packed for a celebration of life full of fans and celebrities. Beyonce and Alicia Keys performed tributes while former NBA stars Michael Jordan, Shaquille O'Neal remembered their friend. Hours before the tribute started, Vanessa Bryant filed a wrongful death lawsuit against the helicopter company. Hundreds of Minnesota students will get a firsthand lesson in politics today. It's Youth Day at the state capitol. Around 300 students are making the trip to St. Paul today. They will get to talk with lawmakers about issues that concern them. And the students will also get to vote for president, but it's, of course, just for fun. They get to cast ballots in a mock presidential primary election. Cool to see how that works, though. Hey, get this, IHOP is adding a sweet topping to its National Pancake Day giveaway, which is today. On top of giving away a free short stack, customers can also enter the Pancakes for Life sweepstakes in the restaurant. You could win $15,000 worth of pancakes, among other prizes. Guests are encouraged to donate the cost of their meal to charity, and the money in Minnesota and Wisconsin goes to Gillette Children's Specialty Healthcare Hospital in St. Paul. Pretty cool there. All right, let's get back to today's talker. We're bringing in WCCO's digital gal, Allie. Allie, what are people saying about Fat Tuesday?
Well, Kimberly says that she's going to eat some junk food today because she tries to give that up for Lent.
Okay.
Becca says that she tried to give up chocolate 1 year, but that didn't go really well.
No, yeah, sometimes you have to weigh in, like, what's going to make you a pleasant person around other people.
I know. I try to give up, you know, fried food.
Okay.
Maybe it doesn't go too hot.
And when you give up junk food, are you more of like a salty person or a sweet person? What's your vice there?
Salty.
Salty. Okay, so you're going to give up something fried and salty.
Yes.
Okay. Good to know. Awesome. Thanks, Allie. Appreciate it. That's it for now. This is the 7:34 from WCCO, when most of the Twin Cities are on the go. So go ahead and make us your place for mobile news. We'll be back here tomorrow at 7:34. And until then, be nice to each other out on the internet.